There's something deeply, almost spiritual about making musical instruments that it's about as close to creating life out of raw materials, wood and strings and tension, and steam bedding these things, but they really take on a life of their own. I've been making guitars for about 40 years, professional woodworker for almost 50 years. I began playing at 10 years old, playing the guitar. At 15 years old, I was offered a woodworking job in this wood shop, restoring old antiques. That began me being around tools, and immediately I started thinking of my guitars, you know. How can I customize them? How can I fix them? Start tearing apart? How do these things get made? A species of Madagascar rosewood. It's absolutely phenomenal tone wood. In my heart, I really love singer-songwriters. So there was a tone that I could hear that goes better with voice in my mind, making it speak. Yeah. So, you can hear it. German Alpine spruce. Different flavors of tone wood, what they do to add to the voice of a guitar. Beautiful. There weren't too many luthiers making a living, so guitars were more of a hobby. I was ultimately offered a job at Santa Cruz Guitar Company. It was fantastic. Made extremely high-end guitars. It was my relationship with David Crosby that really helped me out. We built him a couple of guitars. And he saw some of my work while I was working there. He loved the craft of luthery. And he was talking about a guitar that he always wanted, but never found one. I thought, well, I'm gonna make him one. And he ended up falling in love with this guitar.
It's my favorite guitar.
Has used it on every recording, has toured with it.
And showed up at my gate one day, where I live. He said, my name's Roy McAlister. I used to work at Santa Cruz Guitars and I helped build your 12-string. I made a guitar I want you to play. And I thought to myself, oh, this is going to be bad. You know, I'm some guy with a yo-yo head. Jeez, I got guitars I don't even play, man, but here, let me see it. And he put it in my hand and he put magic in my hand.
That changed my life right there.
I'm real grateful, right?
An article had come out in Acoustic Guitar Magazine of David Crosby speaking highly about my guitars, and the phone just went crazy after that. And then within a week, I got a call from Mark Cohn, Graham Nash, Jackson Brown. Since then, I'd built for Michelle Willis and Becca Stevens, guys like Jeff Pivar and Sean Tubbs, Warren Haynes. When I first started working with Jackson, he likes to work face to face, so he'd come up to my shop and we'd hand guitars back and forth. He'd want this tone or wanted that tone. He'd show me what he liked about certain guitars, playability, tone. He was at our house playing. He's joking around, he goes, oh, any guitar can sound good when you play it quiet, you know, but when you and he's kind of just joking. He said, if you play it really hard, is when you, and he just starts strumming the hell out of the guitar. And my daughter's right behind him. And it startled her. She's only about 2 years old. And she puts her hand over her ears really fast, you know, while he's playing. But it's hilarious. He loves the photo. He's got one in his house. One of my favorite songs that he wrote was a song called These Days. He wrote when he was 16 years old. He used my guitar to play that song every time, every concert for the next, I think, 15 years. It still chokes me up. I've built David probably a dozen guitars for him. and a lot for his friends.
And I just gave one of his guitars to Jeff, right there, today.
We really became close over the years. He really was one of my biggest advocates. And then I got diagnosed with cancer. And so we were both in this nursing ourselves and keeping an eye on each other. You know, up to the day he passed, he and I had been talking regularly. We were really concerned about each other. And we had been talking and laughing just days before he left a message on my cell phone, I think 2 days before he passed. And his last words were, "I love you." Last time I'll hear his voice is him saying, "I love you." And so it ripped me apart when he died. I really lost a dear friend. The music world lost a very creative and driven man. When you finish one, it goes out in the world and you hear it come back to you. A piece of furniture doesn't do that. You build a piece of furniture, you take a picture of it, and you enjoy the picture of it. And a guitar is different. You've created this thing that will then go on and develop and have a voice, and you'll hear it in different ways. It's very rewarding. You know, I never get tired of making the guitars because you never know where it's going to go after that. You don't know who's going to be playing it, who's going to be recording with it. It is more than just a musical instrument. It can be a musical partner.
For more about Roy's gorgeous handcrafted guitars and the artists who play them, go to McAlisterGuitars.com. Catch Art Zone Friday nights at 8 and anytime online at seattlechannel.org/artzone.